So we are going to study today Pascal's law. Any idea what is Pascal's law? You would have studied in school in 11th and I mean to say in 10th, 9th, 10th. Archimedes principle, Pascal's law. Any idea? Does anybody has any idea what is Pascal's law?
No, sir.
Okay. So write down the definition first. So Pascal's law says that pressure at any point in a body of liquid, is the same in every direction. Exerting equal force on equal areas. This works for gases and liquids. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you?
Yes.
So what does it say? So if you see page number 30, they have given an experiment. What does the experiment say? That there is a liquid which is available in this kind of diagram. This is a liquid column and there is a piston available here. And here again you have a piston. And here again it's a piston. The area of the piston is different. Here it is A, here it is A by 2, and here it is 2A. It does not look like 2A. Let me make it 2A. Okay. Here inside all we have is liquid. So Pascal's law says, what it says, that pressure at any point of an enclosed liquid. So liquid is enclosed in this chamber and you have piston all over. There are three openings which you have piston and the area of the piston is different. Here it is A by 2, here it is air, and here is A by 2A. Okay. And we are giving pressure. We are giving force on one side. I'm giving only pressure here. I'm giving force here. Okay. So you know very well that pressure is equal to force by area. Yes or no? Pressure equal to force by area. Yes. That means if we say that pressure in all should be same, that means pressure is nothing but the ratio of force by area. For this one, the ratio is F by A. Let's say this is PA. This is A, this is B, and this is C. So for PA, for piston A, the pressure is F by A. For piston B, FB, what is the area? Area is 2A. Let me catch it is small a. So let us put it small a. And let us do it 2A. So if the pressure has to be same, F by A, then what should be the force? 2F? Yes or no? The ratio has to be same, no? The pressure has to be same. If the pressure has to be same here, then 2F by 2A should be F by A. That means if the area is 2A, then pressure is 2F. Similarly, for PC, it is A by 2. If it is A by 2, then here it should be F by 2. Then only it will be F by A. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That means the pressure, since the Pascal's law, the pressure is same, the force varies in order to make the pressure constant. If everywhere the area would be same, then force will be constant. But since here the areas are different, here it is 2A, here it is A, here is A by 2. The force accordingly adjusts itself or changes to ensure that pressure becomes same. So that the pressure, the force by area ratio is same, which is PA. Hence, PA is equal to PB is equal to PC. Is it clear?
Sir, can you explain the last part again?
So what I'm saying, what does the Pascal's law? Pascal's law says for an enclosed liquid, the liquid is enclosed in this chamber. Understood? It is saying the pressure in all the places, here, 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 everywhere, it is same. So in order to prove that, we applied a force for a piston of area A. We got F by A is the pressure. Since the pressure is same here and here as per the Pascal's law, that means, but the areas are different. Since the areas are different, the force accordingly adjusts itself so that it becomes same. If it is 2A, you cannot have force same. Why? Because F by 2A is half of the force, half of the pressure, but that cannot be. Pressure has to be same. If the pressure has to be same, the ratio has to be same. But ratio can be same only if it is 2A here, it should be 2A here also, 2F here also. Similarly, if it is A by 2, this should also be F by 2. Understood? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, the pressure, so to ensure the pressure is same, the force accordingly adjusts itself across the liquid so that the pressure remains same. Because Pascal's law, so we can say that yes, Pascal's law do exist and it satisfies. Is it clear? Is it clear, guys, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Very, very important. And we will see the applications of Pascal's law slowly. So first example of application of Pascal's law. Have you seen a hydraulic lift? How do they measure, if you have seen big trucks which will carry load, okay, they will have this what do you call this, wheels. How does they find out that how much is the weight of the truck? How do they find out the weight of the load? Let's say the load is please mute yourself or tell somebody to be mute. That's what's going on. So let's say this truck is loaded with bricks. Okay. How we will say that the brick load is 1 ton or 1.5 ton? How do we say? What do we do?
Sir, we take a measurement.
First, the truck is weighed without bricks. Okay. First, the truck is weighed without bricks. How do they weigh? They will use a hydraulic lift. You will see that if the truck is, there will be two sections. Okay. They will put the wheel of the truck here. Understood? And here there will be a pressure chamber. What they will do? They will press it below. When they press it below, this will get lift up. Okay. This will get lift up. That means one man can easily lift a truck. Is it possible for a man to lift it on the top of the head? Normally, no, not possible. But using hydraulic lift, he is able to lift the truck completely on the top. I will show you the video how the hydraulic lift works. So please understand what it is. Okay. So first, they will weigh the empty weight of the truck. Let's say the empty weight of the truck is 100 kg. No, not 100 kg, it will be more obviously. It will be, let's say, 500 kg. Okay, and now they will put what? Bricks, and they will again weigh. With weigh, again they will weigh the truck, it will be something like 800 kg. So now you know the empty weight of the truck, you know the loaded truck. So loaded minus empty is 300 kg. So 300 kg is the load which is given. Did you all understand how they will load the truck? How they will find out the load value?
Yes, sir.
Now we will see what is hydraulic lift. So basically, hydraulic lift will be like this. This is the piston. This is pressure one. This liquid is filled. Obviously, liquid all is filled with liquid. Okay. This is the S1 piston. And this is S2 piston. Obviously, you see the area of the piston S1 is A1. And area of the piston S2 is A2. And you know A2 is greater than A1. It is clear, very well clear. Yes or no? You are applying a force F. Okay. You are applying a force F. So what the person will do, the person will apply a force F on the first piston. So what will happen? Pascal's law says that same amount of pressure will be transmitted here. Yes or no? So if I say P1, can I say P1 is equal to F by F1 by A1? Yes or no? Yes or no? Can I say P1 is equal to F by F1 by A1? And pressure here be equal to the pressure here. They will put the whatever, they'll put the truck and all. Okay. So obviously the truck will get lifted up. So here P2 will be equal to F2 by A2. Yes or no? Yes or no? F2 by?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Then I will say that here F2. Your F2 will become what? P2 into A2. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
F2 will become.
Yes, sir.
P2 into A2. Yes. And we say pressure is same. So P1 is equal to P2. Yes or no? P1 is equal to P2 by Pascal's law. We say no. Same amount of pressure will be transmitted to here also. So if P1 equal to P2, can I write F2 equal to P1 into A2? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And P1 is F1 by A1. So what I will do? I will substitute F2 equal to, instead of P1, I will substitute F1 by A1. So what does my equation becomes? F2 equal to F1 into A2 by A1. That means you can calculate the how much is the force. This force will be massive. This force will be massive. And hence, you are applying only F, but you are getting more than that. And hence, you are able to lift the truck. Did you understand? Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Because of the pressure, say pressure is same, you know the ratio will be same. If the ratio is same, if the A is more, similarly your F also will become more. So F become multifolds. Ideally, normal condition, if I say that you go and lift a truck on your head, is it possible to lift? Is it possible for us to lift a truck? No. But in this way, by the use of hydraulic lift, it is easy. It is easy to lift the truck. Did you understand? Did you guys understand?
Yes, sir.
And the same concept is applied for heavy. Have you seen in D-Marts? They will have some kind of roller. They will keep on rotating, some pressing it, keep on, one big shutter will go. Yes or no? One man is able to lift the big shutter by the most of the places. Where the heavy loads are there, they will use hydraulic lift because this Pascal's law will make your life very easy. Now we will see a video how the hydraulic lift works. okay?
Yes, sir.
Grammarly can help you write quickly and confidently, so you never
can. Can you hear the audio? Is the audio audible?
Yes, sir. It's audible.
Clear, no?
Just slow down at work. Stay on.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See this.
Hello, everyone. We already know about Pascal's law, but we should also know that application of this simple law is enormous. You must have heard the term hydraulics. Hydraulic machines are machinery and tools that use liquid fluid power to do simple work. According to Pascal's law, the pressure applied to an enclosed incompressible fluid is transmitted unchanged to every part of the fluid. Here, there is a model of simple hydraulics that uses the principle. It is a U-shaped tube which has two arms and they are closed by two leak-proof pistons. Now here, the two arms have different cross-section. One arm has much larger cross-section than the other. So here, we say A2 is greater than A1, where A2 and A1 are the cross-sections of the two arms of the U-shaped tube. Now, when we apply force which is equal to F1 to left piston, then it will create pressure which is equal to F1 divided by A1. As we know, pressure is equal to force by area. Now, the cross section of A1 is small, so we can generate greater amount of pressure easily by applying a moderate amount of force. Now, this pressure will transmit equally throughout the fluid and reach the larger tube. Now, here in the larger piston, the pressure would be F1 by A1. So, the total force working on the larger piston would be F2, and force, as we know, is pressure multiplied by total area. Here, pressure is equal to F1 divided by A1. And area is equal to A2. So what is F2? F2 is equal to force divided by area. So this becomes equal to F1 divided by A1 multiplied by A2. Now, in case you have not noticed, the upward force applied on the second tube or the second piston is A2 times the force we applied on the smaller tube or the piston. So we see force gets multiplied many times. Thus, we can generate enough push to lift a heavy car by applying a much smaller downward push in the smaller piston, that is in the left arm. Thus, hydraulics is used to generate huge force by applying much smaller force in many heavy vehicles like bulldozers, trucks, etc. Hydraulic brake is used in heavy vehicles. Hydraulic lifts is used to lift heavy objects. So we see a simple rule can have such huge applications in real life. That's all for now. Bye-bye.
Is it clear, guys? Is it very easy to understand?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So?
Yes, sir.
You saw the lift, you saw the crane, how the crane lifts up this thing. All crane, bulldozer, everything works on that principle. So what the person will have, they will in the driver's seat, the driver's seat will have some kind of like this. So what they will do, he will pull it down. Immediately we pull it down, it will work and this will get lift up. When he pull down, when he pull this side, it will go down. Pull this side, it will go up. Understood? So this works on the, yes or no? Otherwise, is it possible for human to lift such big weights? Not possible. So this is the amazing way that the science has given, that using this law, you can work wonder. you can lift anything using the Pascal's law. So what we saw, that the same force here F2 will become what? A2 times F1 into A1. Earlier, if I'm applying 10 Newton for 10 meter square. Now, if A2 is 100 meter square, that means my force is getting multiplied how many times? 100 times. My force is 1000 Newton. So, just 10 Newton, I'm able to multiply to 1000 Newton. So, my F became how many times? 100F. Did you understand, guys? Did you understand?
Yes.
So that's how I'm able to lift. Is it clear to all? Tarang Swaro.
Yes, sir.
Rishabh clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So now we will go to the next, hydraulic brakes. Hydraulic brakes also are similar. What do? They will have a master piston. That brake, small brake. So you will have some kind of like this in the driver's seat. The driver's seat will have where you will have accelerator. Yes or no? Accelerator, a brake, and a clutch. Am I correct? One is accelerator, brake, and
yes, sir.
Clutch. And this will be four wheels, you'll have four pistons. You'll have four. One will go like this. Sorry. Ignore the drawing. I'm not able to draw properly. But what is...
Sir, आप एक book पे draw कर रहे हैं सर अच्छा मतलब
क्या बोल रहा
हूँ मतलब book पे draw कर पाओगे आप
अरे doesn't matter book में कर पाऊँगा इधर दिक्कत होता है ना करने तो क्या है see ये इसको बोलते हैं slave चारों you have four wheels so you have wheel one wheel two wheel three and wheel four whenever you want to apply brakes do you want to apply brake to only one wheel or four wheels
four wheels
Why? If you apply to one wheel, there is a chance of skidding. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Sir. You will apply whenever the hydraulic brakes are applied, it is first applied to the back wheel and then front wheel. If you apply to front wheel, what will happen? You will be thrown out. Yes or no? The same applies for cycle and bikes also. Whenever you're riding, you should not apply the front wheel first. Either you should apply both wheels or first back wheel first. So in this brake, immediately, same thing, whenever the driver will apply a force F, the master one, this is called master, and this is the slave. Understood? These are slave. Slave one, slave two, slave three. So the master means the one which is under the driver. When the driver presses the brake, it will apply and the area is small a and the force is F. But these areas are maybe double, 2A, 2A, 2A and 2A. So in order to stop the vehicle, a car is maybe how much? Maybe 400 kg or maybe 500 kg. Such a big heavy automobile cannot be stopped immediately with a small human. So what, again, we are using here the Pascal's law, that if the small F is applied for the small area, immediately, because of the liquid, the same amount of pressure is transmitted to all the four slaves, slave piston. And you know that since it is 2A, the pressure, the force has to be 2F because your 2F by 2A is equal to P. And the two, but because you know the pressure here, and here has to be same. The force has to be 2F. Understood? Because area is 2F. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So write down a sentence. Write down a sentence. hydraulic brakes works on the principle of Pascal's law. Hydraulic brakes works on the principle of Pascal's law. As per the law, whenever the pressure is applied on an enclosed fluid, it is transmitted uniformly in all the directions. It is transmitted uniformly in all the directions. Hence, when we apply force on a small piston, the pressure gets created, which is transmitted by the help of the fluid to the larger piston. As a result, a large force gets created. And this helps in uniform braking on all the four wheels. Uniform braking means what? Sabko ek saath rukna. Aisa nahi hai ki ye wala pehle rukega, second wala baad mein rukega. Uniform braking across all wheels. Since the braking force is created due to the hydraulic pressure, they are known as hydraulic brakes. Liquids are used instead of gas, as liquids are incompressible. Guys, clear? Samajh mein aaya sabko?
Yes, sir.
All of you have written down. So let us rejoin, please.